Good morning, boys. Today also, I am going to discuss about basic concept in chemistry. We know this is modern periodic table. Okay, it is based on modern periodic law. The elements are arranged in the increasing order of its atomic number. So, in this periodic table, which is first element? Hydrogen. Then what about the second element? Helium. This is helium. Third element, lithium. Fourth element, beryllium. Like that, boron, carbon, nitrogen. So, what is the atomic number of hydrogen? 1. Atomic number of helium is 2. Lithium, 3. Beryllium, 4. Boron, 5. So, increasing order of its atomic number, the elements are arranged in the periodic table. So, already I said that totally 118 elements are there. Out of 118 elements, 94 are naturally occurring on earth. Remaining are synthesis in the laboratory or radioactive elements. Okay, now these above 118 elements are further classified into S block element, P block element, D block element and F block element. Why these are called like this? Which are called as S block element, which is said to be P block, D block and F block element. We see one by one. So, what are the first element in the periodic table? In the periodic table, the first element is hydrogen, next helium. Okay, so next helium, third one is lithium, like that, arranged in the increasing order of its atomic number. Here, these elements are further classified into S block element, P block element, D block element and F block element. Before that, we want to know what is meaning of period and group. That is, when we move from left to right, that are called as period. When we move from top to bottom, that is called as group. How many periods are there means 7 periods. How many groups are there means 18 groups are there in this chart. So, which is called as period. When we move from left to right, called as period. Move from top to bottom, that is called as groups. Okay. Vertical column is called as group. Horizontal rows are called as period. Totally 7 period and 18 groups are there. So, 7 period and 18 groups. Left to right, you move, that is called as period. Top to bottom, that is called as what? Groups. How many periods are there? 7 periods. How many groups are there? Means 18 groups are there. So, among these 18 groups, first see that in the periodic chart, the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that up to 18. So, 1 and 2, that is the group 1 and 2, these are called as S block element and the 3 to 12 that are called as D block element, 13 to 18 are called as P block element and these are 6th and 7th, these are called as F block element. 1, 2, groups 1, 2 are called as S block element, 3 to 12 D block element, 13 to 18 are called as P block elements. Okay, so what about the first one, 1 and 2, first groups are called as alkali metal. These are alkaline earth metal. These are called as D block elements, otherwise called as transition element. Okay. Now, Why these are called as S block element? What is the reason for that? Why these are called as D block element? Why these are called as P block element means when you write the electronic configuration for the given element, the lost electron enter into S orbital. That's why these are called as S block element. Lost electron enter into S orbital. So these type of elements are called as S block element. Let us consider the first element here, hydrogen. Second one is lithium. Third one is sodium. In first group, I take three element only. So I write atomic number of hydrogen is 1, lithium is 3, sodium is 11. So I write electronic configuration. What is that means? 1s1. Here 1s2, 2s1. Here I write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Okay. So next is what? Potassium. Potassium atomic number is 19. I write electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then 4s1. Like that. Next element is what? Rubidium. So when you write the electronic configuration, the last electron enter in 5s1. When you write the electronic configuration for cesium, last electron enter into 6s1. And francium, it is radioactive element, last electron enter in SN1 orbital. So that these group elements are called as what? These are called as 1s elements. That is the last electron, ns, ns, n means orbital, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are generally referred as, these first group elements are called as ns1. These are called as ns1. Next we go for beryllium, magnesium, calcium, transium, barium, radium. Radium also a radioactive element. When you write the electronic configuration for this element, I write for beryllium. Beryllium atomic number 4. I write electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2. The next one, magnesium atomic number 12. So I write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. After filling 2p6, 3s2. Totally how many electron? Atomic number 12. So you count these numbers. It is equal to 12. So the last electron enter where? 2s. Next element is 3s. Last electron. Outermost shell consists of how many electron? 2 electron only. So that these are, the, what is the general formula? How these are represented means? These are called as ns2. So which are called as D block element? That is the elements belong to group 3 to 12. The elements belong to group 3 to 12 which are called as D block element. When you write the electronic configuration for all these elements, totally how many elements are present in D block means 40 elements are there. Okay, 40 elements are further divided into 4 series. Each series consists of 10 elements. So D block element consists of totally 40 elements. 40 elements are further divided into 4 series. These are, each series contains 10 elements in it. So first series is called as 3D series. When you write the electronic configuration for this, all the electron last shell consists of electron in d orbital only. What type of d orbital means 3D orbital. Like that, when you write the electronic configuration, that's why starting from scandium to zinc, these are called as 3D series. Starting from yttrium to cadmium, the last electron enter into 4D, that's why these 10 elements are called as 4D series. Hafnium to Mercury, the last electron enter into 5D, that's why these are called as 5D series. This is incomplete series, the last electron enter into 6D, that's why these are called as 6D series. Like that, D block elements are classified into 4 types, 3D series, 4D series, 5D series, 6D series, in which 6D is incomplete one. Okay, so otherwise these are called as transition element. Why these are called as D block elements are called as transition element? Why these are called as transition element? The property of these D block elements, this pink color, 40 elements. Here lanthanum, here actinium is there. Okay, these 40 elements are called as D block element, otherwise called as transition element. Why these are called as transition element means the property of all these elements are in between S and P block element. Here S block element, there P block elements are there. The property of this is in between S and P, that's why these 14 elements are otherwise called as transition element. Now, so the group 1, the elements belong to group 1 and 2 are called as S block 1 and 2, called as S block element, and 3 to 12, these are called as D block element. D block elements, the elements belong to group 13 to 18 are called as P block element. These are called as P block elements. And F block elements, F block elements otherwise called as lanthanides and the actinoids. So here see that 57 actually lanthanum. Totally how many elements are present in F block element? When you write the electronic configuration, these 14 elements end with F orbital. That's why these are called as F block elements. All these are radioactive element. Here promethium only radioactive element. All these are radioactive element. Okay, so totally how many elements are there means 15 elements. Here also 15 elements including lanthanum and actinium. The property of these 14 elements similar to that of lanthanum. That's why these 15 elements collectively called as lanthanoid series. Like that, starting from thorium to lawrencium. Thorium to lawrencium, totally 14 elements are there. The property of these 14 elements are similar to that of actinium. That's why these 15 elements collectively called as actinoid series. These F block elements called as lanthanide or actinoid. Otherwise, these are called as inner transition element. Why these F block elements? These are in our plus 2 and 11th standard. These are important. Two more questions. Why D block elements are called as transition element? Why F block elements are called as inner transition element? D block elements are called as transition element because the property of D block elements are in between S and P block element. Like that, why F block elements are called as inner transition element means these are like, see, atomic number 57. After that, atomic number 58, 59 up to 71. These are F block element. They form a series in between the D block. That's why these are called as inner transition element. Okay. So, among these, some are metal, some are non-metal, some are semi-metal. So when we move from top to bottom down the group, metallic character increases. At the top, non-metallic character is more. At the bottom, metallic character is increases. But all these 40 elements in D blocks are metal only. All these 40 elements are metal only. Okay, but when we move from P block element, which are called as P block element, the elements belong to group 13 to 18 called as P block elements. So here boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, all are non-metal. So at the top, non-metallic character increases when we move from top to bottom down the group. Top to bottom down the group. Vertical column. Vertical column is called as group. Horizontal rows are called as period. Left to right you move period. That is horizontal rows. When we move from top to bottom, that are called as group. Vertical column is called as group. So when we move from top to bottom down the group, metallic character increases. Okay. So what about the, it is a special case, 18 group element. 18 group element are otherwise in the beginning these are referred as 0 group element. And why these are called as 0 group element means when you write the electronic configuration except helium, all other element. What are that all other element present here? Neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Okay, these are, radon is a radioactive element. So except helium, what is the atomic number of helium? Atomic number of helium is 2. That's why you write electronic configuration 1s2. Okay, then neon. When you write the electronic configuration for neon, atomic number 10, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Outermost cell, which is outermost cell here? 2s, 2p. Both s orbital and p orbitals are present in the second cell. So the number of electron present in the outermost cell is how many? 8. So completely filled. That's why it is chemically inactive. Inert. That's why these are called as inert gas. These are called as inert gas. That's why in the beginning these are considered as a 0 group. But in the modern periodic table, it is placed in the 18th position. What are the elements are present in the 18th group? That are called as noble gases, otherwise called as inert gases. All are gases except radon is a radioactive element. Okay, so I said many times electronic configuration. What is the meaning of electronic configuration? For writing electronic, I write something here. How will you write everything? By using valency. In last class, I discussed about valency. What is meaning of valency? How will you write the valency? How will you find out the valency? This is the basic in chemistry. That's why I talk about now this, what is meaning of valency. And what is the main difference? One more term is called as oxidation number. Oxidation number otherwise called as oxidation state. So what is the main difference between valency and oxidation number otherwise called as oxidation state? We discuss now one by one with a suitable example. Clear boys? Okay. So what is a period? It is very important. I remember all these 118 elements in, let us consider. See that this is actinium, thorium, proactinium, uranium, neptunium, plutonium, americium, curium, like that. This name is very difficult to remember that one. I remember like this only. See, AC theater la, balcony la, unakaga, na, pudu, America CM kitta, book pannirken, coffee ya, easy ya. FM ல பாட MD நோ சொன்னதால லாரியில அனுப்பிட்டேன். If you remember like that, I remember this element like that. Sun TV ல குரோர்பதி நடத்த மேனேஜர் பெக்கோனி, நேம் ஆஃப் மேனேஜர் பெக்கோனி, குஷன் சீட்டில் உட்கார்ந்தார். Okay, like that I remember all the elements. Yellow jerkin அணிந்த NB மோகன், TC வாங்க ரூபன் ரோகனோட பெல்லேடியம் சில்வர் போட்ட பேனாவை எடுத்துட்டு CD வாங்கினான். Like that I remember all this element. You follow yourself whatever you like. So, லேசி பிரணாத் பிஎம் கூட்டிட்டு சீனியர் மேனேஜரோட யூரோப் சென்றா. ஜிடி நாயுடுக்கு டிபி டயாபெட்டிஸ் இருந்ததால ஹாஸ்பிட்டல் சென்றார். தமிழ்நாடு எல்லோ பூக்கள் லுக்காக இருந்தது. இஃப் யூ ரிமெம்பர் லைக் திஸ் இட் இஸ் ஈஸி ஃபார் யூ வென் எவர் யூ டச் யுவர் என்ட்ரன்ஸ் போர்ஷன். திஸ் எலிமெண்ட் நேம் அண்ட் இட்ஸ் அட்டாமிக் நம்பர் இஸ் வெரி வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ட்ரை ஃபார் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வாட் ஆர் த எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் பிரசன்ட் ஹியர். ஓகே, ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த லிட்டில் இன்ட்ரோடக்ஷன் அபவுட் பீரியாடிக் டேபிள். ஸோ பீரியாடிக் டேபிள் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தி இன்க்ரீசிங் ஆர்டர், ஆல் த எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் அரேஞ்ச்ட் இன் த இன்க்ரீசிங் ஆர்டர் ஆஃப் இட்ஸ் அட்டாமிக் நம்பர். ஓகே, தீஸ் ஆர் ஃபர்தர் கிளாஸிஃபைடு இன்டூ எஸ் பிளாக், பி பிளாக், டி பிளாக் அண்ட் எஃப் பிளாக் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ். அண்ட் வென் வி மூவ் ஃப்ரம் லெஃப்ட் டு ரைட் அலாங் த லெஃப்ட் டு ரைட் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் எஸ் பீரியட். டோட்டலி ஹவு மெனி பீரியட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் மீன்ஸ் 7 பீரியட்ஸ். வென் வி மூவ் ஃப்ரம் டாப் டு பாட்டம் தட் ஆர் கால்ட் எஸ் குரூப்ஸ். டோட்டலி ஹவு மெனி குரூப்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் மீன்ஸ் 18 குரூப்ஸ் ஆர் தேர். ஓகே, இன் ஈச் பீரியட் ஹவு மெனி எலிமெண்ட்ஸ். ஸோ சம் ஆர் மெட்டல், சம் ஆர் நான் மெட்டல், சம் ஆர் செமி மெட்டல். ஓகே, ஸோ வை தே ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் செமி மெட்டல் ஆர் அதர்வைஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் மெட்டலாய்டு. த ப்ராப்பர்டிஸ் ஆஃப் சர்டைன் மெட்டல்ஸ் ஆர் இன்பிட்வீன் மெட்டல் அண்ட் நான் மெட்டல். சச் டைப் ஆஃப் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் மெட்டலாய்ட்ஸ் ஆர் அதர்வைஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் செமி மெட்டல். ஓகே, வாட் ஆர் த செமி மெட்டல் மீன்ஸ் திஸ் ஒன் சிலிகான், ஆர்சனிக், டெல்லூரியம். திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் antimony and tellurium. These are, this one is called as what means semi metal. These are called as semi metals. Okay, next, so in each period, that is another important point you want to note, that whenever they ask about periodic table means you write like this means you get more mark. So what about that next one means totally how many periods are there means 7 period. In each period, how many elements are there? That is, how many periods are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is a period? When we move from left to right. When we move from left to right, here, left to right, how many elements are there? Only 2 elements are, number of elements. Number of elements. How many in first, this is period, period. So when we move from left to right, first period, how many elements are there? 2 elements are there. When we move from second one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So second period, how many elements are there means 8. Like that, third period, totally how many elements are there means 8 elements are there. Fourth period, when we move from left to right, that is called as period. So how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So what about that? Fourth period, how many elements are there means 18. Like that, fifth period also how many? 18. What about sixth period? Listen carefully. Sixth period, see that. Here, atomic number 72, 2. How many? 86 is there. What about the remaining? The first element in sixth is what? 1, 2. After that, one is missing, 57. Actually, 57 is what means? Lanthanum. That is actually located here. Because it is a D block element, the property of these element, these 14 elements are similar to that of lanthanum. That's why it is also placed along with these 14 elements, so that these are called as lanthanoids. But actually what is the position of this lanthanum is here only. So here, after that, 58 to 71 is here. Totally, how many elements are there? Here 18, here 14. Totally, how many elements are there means 32. Like that, here atomic number what? 87, 88, 89, actinium. 89 is nothing but actinium. After that, 92, 103. Here, which is which one is atomic number of rutherfordium? 104. Up to 103, F block element. Starting from 104 to 118 that are called as D block element. So here also you count these two, totally how many means 32, like this. Totally 7 periods are there. Among the 7 period, first period number of element is 2, second period 8, third period 8, fourth period 18, fifth one also 18, sixth and 7 are 32. Like that, you want to know the basic in the periodic table chart. Okay, next topic is nothing but how will you fill the electrons in the orbital of different atom? Which principle is used for that? Means filling of electron in a given orbital is called as electronic configuration. Filling of an electron in the orbital of the different atom takes place by using the principle is nothing but Hopf principle. What is, I write here, electronic, this is called as electronic configuration. It is nothing but filling of an electron in the orbital. What are that orbital? Orbit is nothing but K, L, M, N. What is orbital? S, P, D, F. Okay, so S, P, D, F are called as orbital. So in which, how will you fill that electron? We see by using the rule is nothing but, the principle is nothing but Hopf principle. What is meaning of Hopf principle? That is, in the ground state of atom, the orbitals are filled in the order of their increasing energies. Two more question. State Hopf principle, very basic one. In the ground state of the atoms, the orbitals are filled in order of their increasing energies. What is the increasing energy? Already I discussed in last class, an atom is nothing but sphere in shape in which around the nucleus electrons are revolved in a circular path. Okay, so listen the diagram. Here nucleus is made by proton and neutron. Around these electrons are rotate in the circular path. Okay, this is called as first cell K. I recollect that point, K, L, M, N. So this is a first cell for any atom. Which is a first cell means orbit, main cell is what means K, second one is what L, third is M, N and going on. So K cell, here it is a first cell, it is represented by a quantum number called as principal quantum number. Symbol for principal quantum number is nothing but n, small n. So it is a first cell, that's why it is referred as 1. Second cell, n equal to 2. Third cell, principal quantum number for third cell is 3. Fourth cell is 4. Already I discussed, that is first cell, not only electrons revolve in a circular path, also elliptical path. So that the electrons are enter in that orbitals are S, P, D and F. Shapes of orbital. So already we know that here K cell, S orbital is there, L is a second cell, 2 orbital, these are S and P, then third cell, M cell, how many subcells are there means 3 subcells that are nothing but S, P, D. And the fourth main cell, what are the 4 subcell means S, P, D and F. Fourth cell, fourth main cell, how many subcells are there means S, P, D and F. So which is a lowest level means S. So this is a first one, that's why I referred as 1s. Then this is a second cell. Second cell, how many orbitals are there that are represented as 2s and 2p. Here how many cells are there? 3 subcells are there. That's why this is a third energy level. So all these 3 are referred as 3s, 3p, 3d. Here this is a fourth one. So these are referred as 4s, no place. That's why I write like this. 4s, 4p, 4d, 4F. So, before discuss about this topic, we want to know little idea about shapes of orbital. S orbital is spherical in shape. It is spherical in shape. What about P orbital? It is, S orbital is non-directional in nature. We discuss in detail in our 11th standard portion. I give only little idea about shape of orbitals. In P orbitals, what is the shape of P orbital means dumbbell shape. Now, these P orbitals are further represented as Px, Py and Pz. Why these P orbitals are referred as Px, Py and Pz means the probability of finding of an electron is maximum in x-axis. That's why these are referred as Px orbital. What is orbital? You know very well. That is 3D region around the nucleus. The probability of finding of an electron varies maximum are called as orbital. That's why the probability of finding of an electron is maximum in which axis? X-axis. That's why these are referred as Px orbital. Now, if the probability of finding of an electron, in P orbital is maximum in Y-axis means, in Y-axis, three-dimensional way you represent, all are imaginary one. So, X, Y, Z. Now, the probability of finding of an electron is maximum in the form of dumbbell, then these are referred as what orbital means? Py orbital. Like that, if I represented like this, the probability of finding of an electron in Z orbital is maximum, then these are referred as Pz orbital. Like that, totally how many P orbital means? Px, Py, Pz. Okay, so P orbitals are started in which energy level? Second energy level. So here 2P, it can be written as 2Px, 2Py, 2Pz. Like that. Next, we go for D orbitals. What is a D orbital shape is nothing but flower leaf shape. Totally how many d orbital means? 5 d orbitals are there. So what about the d orbital shape means flower leaf shape. So what about that means? Here I write x axis, that is y axis. So then these orbitals are, how many dumbbells are there? 2 dumbbells are there. These the 2 dumbbells are lie in between the axes. So, what are that axes? X and Y. The probability of finding of an electron is maximum here and here only. That's why this orbital is represented as DXY orbital. Instead of, what about that? I write here X, that is here Z, here Y. Then the probability of finding of an electron is maximum here only. So now what type of this orbital? This is nothing but DYZ orbital. Then this is Z, then this is X means, this is called as what orbital means? DZX orbital. This shape is called as clover leaf shape. Then totally how many D orbitals I wrote? 3. Now what about the fourth one? The fourth one is, this is very important, one more question in 11th standard as well as 12th standard. Among the following, which is differ from other, like that they ask in our one more question. So that, see that, now the two dumbbells here lie, this is x axis, I write this is y axis. So here what is the difference between these three and this one? Means here the lobes are lies in between the axis, here that lobes are lies along the axis. So this is referred as dx square minus y square orbital. The fourth one is dx square minus y square. Main difference is the lobes are lie along the axis here, here in between the axis. The fifth one of d orbital is nothing but the shape. Dumbbell, electron cloud, donut shape of electron cloud in the center part. This is referred by a symbol d either square. Okay, dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square, d either square. Like that, totally how many d orbital means 5 d orbital. How many s orbital? Only one type of s orbital, spherical in shape. How many p orbital? 3 p orbital. How these are represented? Px, py, pz. How many d orbitals? 5 d orbitals. And how many f orbital? 7 f orbitals. They are indefinite shape. Up to we discuss that one later. So totally f orbitals are 7 s orbital, 3 p orbital, 5 d orbital, 7 f orbital. This is one of the important basic concept. You want to fill the electron in a given orbital of any atom. Okay, so how will you fill that electron in a given orbital? Means by using what principle? Means alpha principle. What is alpha principle? In the ground state of the atoms, the orbitals are filled. What are the orbitals? S, p, d, f are filled in the order of their increasing energies. First you enter LKG, then UKG, then first standard, second standard, like that. What is the lowest energy level here? 1s. And then second energy level, what? 2s. After filling that electron in 2s, we go for what? 2p. So that principle is diagrammatically, in simple way, we can represent that is called as alpha principle. Increasing energies. What are, that is, orbitals are filled in order of their increasing energies. So how will you write that one? Means that also very important for you. That also very important for you. See that? I draw that. Alpha principle can be represented as first energy level. Which orbital is there? 1s. What about the second one? Second orbital. Second main cell, how many orbital? 2. So that are 2s, 2p. Then third cell, what are that orbital? 3s, 3p, 3d. Fourth one, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. Then fifth energy level available means what about that? Fifth energy level is nothing but you can write 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f. Like that. So far the element enter in f orbital only. That's why we stop up to f orbital. Next we go for 6s, 6p, 6d, 6f. Like that. So what is the ground state for any atom is 1s. Okay. Ground state means first energy level is referred as 1s. So first filling electrons, lower energy to higher energy, LKG, then UKG. LKG, then UKG, 2s. After filling 2s, we go for a next one, what? 2p. After filling 2p, we go for what? 3s. After filling 3s, we move towards, listen carefully, this is important. You move here 3s. After filling 3s, we move towards what? 3p. After filling 3p, we move towards 4s, not 3d. Even though 3d is present here, which is lower energy level, very, very important, boys. When you write the electronic configuration, we need this basic knowledge. Concentrate here, 1s, see that. Move like this. Upward direction, downward direction, next say upward direction, down, up. After filling 3p, next we move where? 4s. After filling 4s, then only we move to 3d. After filling 3d, then only we move 4p. Then like this. Like this you want to draw. Okay. So this is the simple diagram, simple form of Auer principle. Based on this only, you want to fill the electron in the given orbital of any atom. We see how will you fill the electron in a given atom. Now we consider. I write some example. First element is hydrogen, second one is helium, third lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, up to 10 I write first. Okay, so hydrogen atomic number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, how many these? It is nothing but atomic number for hydrogen. So, what is its first energy level? You refer the diagram. First energy level, how many orbitals are there? One. So, how will you fill electron in a given orbital? The formula is nothing but, that is 2n square. Filling of electron in the orbital follow the rule is nothing but 2n square. Okay. Now n is what? 1. N equal to 1. So what about that? Means 2 into 1 square equal to 2. N equal to 2, 2 into 2 square. 2 2s are 4 into 2 are 8. N is 3. What about that? 2 into 3 square. 3 2s are 3 into 3, 9. Plus 2, sorry, into 2, which equal to 18, like that, n equal to 4, 2 into 4 square, so 16 plus 2, 32, like that, we fill that electron. So, last class, I discussed that, K cell, n equal to 1, n equal to 2, n is 3, n equal to 4, this is basic one, so n equal to 1. Main cell, or I write orbit, orbit, K, L, M, N, orbital, this is first cell, that's why you write 1s, N equal to 2, how many cells are there, 2s, 2p, N equal to 3, how many subcells are there, 3, they are nothing but 2s, 2p, sorry, 3s, 3p, 3d, and the fourth one is 4s, 4p, 4d, and 4f. In the diagram, you check that one. 1s, 2s, 2p. So, n is 1. How many electron? Number of electron. This is nothing but number of electron. N is 1. Then, how many electrons are there? 2 electrons. So, in s orbital, in the first cell, how many electrons are there? 2 electrons are there. Next, n equal to 2. How many electrons are totally? 8 electrons. Already we know that in s orbital, how many electrons? 2 electrons. That's why here also how many electrons? 2 electrons. Totally how many electrons are there? 8. After filling s orbital 2 electrons, remaining how many electrons are there? 6 electrons. So, in second cell, maximum electron how much? 8 electron. N equal to 3, total number of electrons? 18. Already you know very well, number of electron S is 2. P is how much? 6. So, 8 over. Remaining how much? In D orbital, 10. Like that. N is 4, 32. S how much electron? 2. P, 6 electron. D means maximum electron 10, 10, 18, remaining how much? 14. That's why in, this is a very, very fundamental boys, concentrate. You understand this concept means then everything is easy in chemistry, otherwise you feel very difficult, that's why you concentrate. Formula, orbitals are filled using electron by a formula is 2n square. So, you substitute n value 1, 2, 2 means you get that maximum electron in first cell is 2, that enter in s orbital and 8 electron in the second shell, 2 in s orbital, remaining 6 in p orbital. Like that, 2 in s orbital, 3 in fixed 3p orbital, remaining electron 10 enter in d orbital. So what about that? These 2p further divided into how many orbital? 3 orbitals. So according to Hund's rule, what is Hund's rule means? No pairing occur. What is Hund's rule? You know very well. No pairing occur until orbitals of a given subshell are half filled. These are called as Hund's rule. What is Hund's rule means? No pairing occurs until all orbitals of a given subshell are half filled. Okay, so here p orbitals, you can write like this itself. Otherwise, it is divided into, this can be divided into 2px, 2py, 2pz. This can be represented by diagram. How many orbitals? 3 orbitals. So, this can be represented like this. Orbitals can be represented like this. 2p, total number of electrons are how much? 6. So, these 6, each orbital carry how many electrons means? 2. So, this can be represented like this. One electron move upward direction, another one move in downward direction. It carry the charges plus half, this carry minus half. So, maximum electron in p orbital is how many means? 6. So, this is called as completely filled, because maximum electron in p orbital is 6. All are completely filled means these are called as completely filled electronic configuration. Okay, now like that d orbital, totally how many? 5 d orbital. Number of electron in d orbital is 10. So, 5 d orbitals. What are that? Dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square, dz square. So, each carry how much electron? 2 electron, totally 10. So, you can write like this. Each orbital occupy only 2 electron, maximum electrons 2 only. Like that, f orbital, totally how much means? 7. 7. So, total number of electron, 7 orbitals, f orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Each carry 2 electrons. Okay, boys. Okay, so this is another basic one. So, p orbitals are px, py, pz. They filled like that. D orbitals 10, filled like that. D orbitals like that. Okay, next we go for this one. So, atomic number for hydrogen is 1. So, what is the first cell for hydrogen? 1s. 1s. Here, number of electron how much? 1. That's why 1 electron only. Then, helium. First cell, n equal to 1, 1s, 2. Atomic number of helium is 2. So, it is filled, that the electrons are filled in 1s only. Maximum electron in s orbital is 2. That's why you fill it 2. Then, lithium, 1s. Maximum electron in 1s is what? 2. After filling these 2 electrons, we move next part is what? 2s. So, 2s. Remaining how much electrons are there? 1 electron. So, 2 plus 1, 3 electron. Like that, beryllium. Beryllium, 4. So, you go for alpha principle, move to alpha principle. First cell, 1s, 2 electron. Second cell, 2s, in which maximum electron are how much? 2 only. Next cell, like that you fill it. Okay. See that, atomic number 5, first energy level 1s, 2, next you move alpha principle, that diagram, last one I wrote there, you know, that diagram, next 2s, maximum electron 2, 2 plus 2, 4, remaining how much electron? 1 electron, so remaining enter where? 2p1, that 2p1 is what? 2px1, or simply you can represent 2p1 itself enough. Otherwise, you write 2p, 1 electron. Like that here. Oh, what about that? 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. 2p2. Then, this can be represented as last. What about these? These are called as nitrogen. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Listen carefully, boys. What about Hund's rule? Here we apply Hund's rule. Listen. So, what about the Hund's rule? Last cell. This is called as outermost or valence cell. 2s, 2p. For this atom, this is referred as what? Outermost cell or valence cell. Here I write 2p3. So, how many totally p orbital? 3 orbital. 3 orbital. So, I fill this 2p orbital, these 3 electron like this. If I write like this means this is wrong statement. According to Hund's rule, that is what is already I informed you, no pairing occur. That word is very important, no pairing occur until all orbitals of a given subcell are half filled. Given subcells are half filled. Don't write like this. How will you write this one means half filled. What is meaning of half filled? First you enter one electron in this room, another electron enter in this room, next electron enter in this room. This is a right one, this is wrong one. Okay, don't enter two electron, minimum one electron in each orbital. Next you go for oxygen. See that oxygen, what about atomic number 8? 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 4. So remaining what? 4. So in p orbital, maximum electron s is 2, it is completed. Outermost cell is what? 2p, in which totally how many electrons are there? 4. So this 4 can be filled. P orbital totally 3. So first 1, 1, 1. So after filling 3 orbital, remaining 3 electron, remaining how many electrons are there? One more electron is there, that only enter here. After filling single electron, these are called as single electron or unpaired electron. If two are present like that means these are referred as paired electron. Clear boys? So next fluorine. Listen, atomic fluorine, atomic number 9. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 4, 4, remaining how much? 5. So this 5, how will you fill in p orbital? Totally p orbitals are 3. Number of electron in p orbital is 5. So first I fill 1, 1, half filled. Remaining 2 more electron that are enter here. Okay, in this way you want to represent, this rule is called as Hund's rule. Okay, so any element possesses completely, next day, neon, atomic number 10, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, what about that, 10, here 6, so here, p orbital, totally how many electron, 1, 2, 3, remaining 3 more electron, you enter here. Now, maximum electron in p orbital is how much, 6, maximum electron in p orbital is 6, so in neon, this p orbital, all electrons are completely filled. That's why this type of configuration, completely filled electronic configuration. What about these two? These two are referred as partially filled electronic configuration. These are completely filled, these are partially filled. Okay, boys, remaining part I discuss in next class.